Hi and welcome to another session. This time I'm not going to show something about AX7, but I thought to do something in AX2012. Basically just let me also have some topics in here. Today I'm going to show you actually how, or actually we are going to try to set up the purchase requisition where basically a case is quite simple. So an employee wants to order over the employee self-service a laptop out of a purchase catalog. This purchase requisition needs to be approved from his boss, and in the end the purchasing department creates a purchase order directly out of the purchase requisition. The purchase requisition will be done over the employee self-service, which is actually nothing else than something on the enterprise portal, so over the web. As always, the system is fully blank, so we really start from scratch with everything to set up in the end, so just that you see what you need to do if you start with a blank system. So, first of all, what we need to do is actually that we need to go to Product Information Management, and that we are going to create the category hierarchy types and category hierarchies. It's actually nothing else than just the categories, how it is added, like category phones, category tablets, category laptops, whatever. So in the end, you just need to click in here, and you see there are already some available because it is a shared table which is available for all mandates. So if there is any kind of other mandate within this installation, then you will see all the category hierarchy types from all of them. But we are going to create a new one. We need to have the procurement category hierarchy. And I'll just quickly say my category hierarchy. My category hierarchy. Which of course doesn't yet exist, so I just click on view details. Fortunately in here it is possible, not as it is in AX7 currently. So I need to start with the category hierarchies. So I already clicked on the wrong thing, so category hierarchies. Good. New hierarchy, I call it my category 1, and I just click on create. Good. Okay, now I can actually start to create nodes. So I say, for example, the main node will be internal supplies. Good. That's fine. I can add description. Internal supplies to be ordered from employees. Friendly name, internal supplies. Okay, I'm not going to talk about category attributes in the end. It's just kind of text and kind of numbers that you can add. I'm also not going to talk about commodity codes. Category page, yeah, that's add one, name, and perfect. So, yeah, category attributes would be really just like if you want to add any kind of information like text. So, for example, you can say, okay, I want to add here kind of a brand. Click here on select, and okay, then I have in the end here the possibility to add a kind of brand. Of course, the attribute types need to be created. There is also a menu item directly available in the procurement and sourcing. You will find it's also quite simple over on the setup. Good, I create a new node, and then I say, well, okay, I create the subcategory laptops. Laptops. Good, and also in main. And save. And next one, phones, and just copy paste it. Yeah, as you can see, you're quite free how you want to create it. So it's really just up to you. You can create subcategories of the subcategories, and so on and so on. So it's really just kind of a tree. So let's create the last one, tablets. And associate it to hierarchy type. So the thing that we did tried before. So I click on this one here, and I click on new, and I can say procurement category hierarchy, and my category hierarchy is just my category. Perfect. So this means we can go back to product information management. Now, next step would actually be that we are going to add the products to those hierarchies. As you can see, the attributes are in the end actually in here. So for this, we need to switch the module to the procurement and sourcing module. And in here, we have the categories and procurement categories. So we can just click on this one here. And perfect, as you can see, we already have our tree that we've created before. Perfect. So let's start. So we have here a subcategory where we have laptops and phones. So let's maybe start with the phones. So what I need to do, of course, I need to allocate the products which are within this category in here. So I just click here on add, and I can search for my product number. It's again here, you see all products which are available in all mandates. So it can be that you need to search. So we are on phones, so I'm searching for Windows phone. Perfect, I select it, I click on OK, I can go to tablet, I can also say add, and I can say surface, good, I can select this one, and maybe this one as well, and I can click on OK. Good. So let's assume you have here one group. So I add different kind of products. I could add here the product attribute. So for example, like the brand and things like this. So just kind of information about the products. The vendors. Good. So I can say what kind of vendors are delivering these kind of things. So for example, I can say, well, those two are delivering tablets, so the purchasing department in the end can choose between one of those where they want to order it. Okay, the vendor evaluation things, we don't have a look at it as well, definitely not the questionnaires. Also, the item sales tax group is not mandatory because normally it is directly coming from the item. You would be able to say, well, okay, I don't put it on the item master data but on the category. But it actually does not make that much sense, so in the end, yeah. Good, so this was it for here already, the setup that we need to do. As you can see, we don't have any laptops yet, so we just quickly create a new item for the laptops. So, yeah, let's go to product information management, just quickly create a new item. So I just say here, I want to have a new item, it is non-stocked, so let's say, and product name is Lenovo V541, so perfect, and copy paste, item, model group, non-stocked items, item group, it is non-stocked, it is site, and it is, of course, non, and we have full, and okay, and to make my life easier later on, I'm going inventory management, and I quickly add the default order setup that I have here, the site one, always if it is ordered. Perfect, so let's go back to procurement and sourcing, and we are back on the procurement categories. And now we have a laptop, so now I can go and say I want to add this product. I select it and click on OK. If I want to, okay, so we have the product in here now. I also say in here I'm going to add some kind of vendors, so those three for example, and okay, perfect. So, actually also not sure if this will be shown, but let's quickly go back to my released item and let's just add a product image. So just that we maybe have the ability in here that we see later on. So I just choose here the type. There should be a new type, I guess. So let's quickly say new image homepage, maybe. Is there create application syntax and blah blah blah? No, it's not. Let's try it with file. Okay. Please don't use your C temp because no one else would ever be able to see it, just yourself. So therefore, put it somewhere where everyone had access. But so perfect. I choose this one. The record already exists. Strange. So yeah, there would be just kind of a different type which needs to be set up, and then it should work. Perfect. Okay, so what next? So before we can start to create the procurement catalogs, we actually have to create the purchasing policies. So it means nothing else than we just need to click here on the purchasing policies. Have to create a new one, and let's just call it my company policy. I'm choosing the mandate, which is the churn one, I guess. Is it the churn one? How is this one called? Denf is Contos Entertainment System Germany. So this one, okay, perfect. So I need to create some policies, which means nothing else. I need to create a catalog policy rule. So I just click here on create one. And that's a pity, of course, I need to create first the catalog. Sorry. As I said, I'm also doing it the first time. So please forgive me if I'm not just doing click by click and everything is working. So in the end, we are going to create now the procurement catalog. Again, it's a shared table, so you see all catalogs from all the different mandates, so for example, here from the USMF. But we are going to create a new one, I say my catalog, and populate catalog using procurement, makes sense. Perfect, and now I have here my tree, internal supplies, laptops, phones, tablets, and so on. Okay, let's just go to the edit mode. So it means nothing else than the products should be in. So they are in, the vendors should be in, they are in. External catalog link would be if you want to actually import supplier catalogs into AX. So if you have supplier which have kind of things available that he can give you, and then you can upload it that you have his items in the end. So, for our case, we actually don't need to add anything in here. And here as well not, and here as well not. We just save it because all the other things were already done before. So, let's go back to the purchasing policies. And now I have it here. So, it means now I can go and say catalog policy rule, create policy rule, and I'm choosing in here. Still, let's go back. There is still something wrong. Not any catalogs. But I wanted to go to the procurement catalogs, my catalog, and I need to activate it. It is activated, and now I can finally do the purchasing policy. So I just click in here and I create the new policy and I choose my catalog, which is now available. I click on OK. Good. The category access policy rule needs to be created as well. So I create on new and I say, well, everything should be added. So I just tick those and I select this one here, select this one here, and select this one here. And by adding the first one, the parent is also added automatically if you tick this flag there. Okay, the category policy rule needs to be created as well. So create policy rule, click on add. And now what you can do in here is actually that you say, well, who can have access or who have access to what? So I just choose here the first one. I can say, well, all vendors can see it. You can also say just those which are preferred and approved. You can give them a questionnaire if you want, but in the end, we are definitely not doing that. So I just add every category that all vendors and all the internals and everyone can actually access to it without any problems. Next, the reapproval rule for purchase order needs to be created as well. So I just click here on create rule. And here is a big tree where you have quite a lot of different kind of options where you can say who can access what and when and whatever. In our case, we just click on OK because everything is basically good. So next would be the purpose rule. So we create it and we can say, well, is it a consumption, is it replenishment, or is he able to override it manually? So if he can choose, so that's fine. Close it. And the last one would be the purchase order creation and demand consolidation rule. Again, create policy rule, and in here you would have quite some options regarding price discount transfers and so on, so just trade agreements and price tolerances and whatever. So I just click here cancel the purchase requisition line, automatically create the purchase order demand consolidation. Always allow. Close, and that's fine. In the parameters, we need to do a setup as well. So we need to click to the parameters. We need to ensure that there is the company in it. And in the policy rule, this one is basically fine. So, but just ensure that there is an order of preference. So if it would like this, look like this, then if it would be on the left side, then just add it in the end. So perfect. Good. So this means now actually that we already have our procurement catalog and we should be able now to have a look at it. So let's just quickly try it. And as you can see, there is one problem. My user is from the USMF, so I'm ending up on their thing in the end. So I want to go to them, of course. Just first of all, let's quickly add some information as well. So let's go back to the catalog. So my catalog, I can just say here presentation, and you can click on edit, and you can add any kind of text. So I can say hello, welcome to my nice internal webshop. So you can close it. I didn't want to close nothing, so just quickly go back. Perfect. Okay. Good. So before automatically the USMF mandate opened, it's just because my user is actually at the moment a worker of USMF and not a worker from DEMF. So this means nothing else than I need to ensure that I have a worker. I am a worker from the correct mandate, so I just go in here and just hire myself first. So I'm from them, I can have this number, I hire myself, first things the system needs to know who I am. So it just have my admin user. So I need to make relation between my system user, which is admin, and my user itself. And I'm not importing Litten. I just click here on new relation and I'm going to search myself. So the employee self-service from DEMF should open as soon as I go here to the procurement catalogs, and that's mean because I've sorry, I need to create a new one. My catalog 2, but it should not be a big deal. So ensure that before you create this catalog that you are already in the correct mandate. So this means perfect. I can click, close it, and now I can go in here to my catalog too, and I need to click on activate, and of course the policy. Perfect, so you see now here, hello, feel free to order something, so just my text that I've added before. So I'm the employee now and I want to order something, so if I open up here, then I can see the different categories, so I can say, well, I want to order a laptop, and I can search for the laptops. And as you can see, the grid is empty. Yeah, so definitely not what we wanted. Anyhow, so let's go back to AX. Maybe just at first something else, but just quickly. So you are able to add kind of product groups and how the product should be presented. I have honestly no clue what is going to happen, but in here you are some product groups. You are able just to create kind of notes, so I just say group node, I can save it, I create also an item node, and I choose here type item node, and I can select items. Of course I can click here on the select button and then I can add normal queries. But I just leave it as it is, so just add every one of them. So down there I have now all items because I didn't make any kind of selection, and I can say in here in presentations I can add kind of descriptions. So for example I can say here on edit and I can say this is a novel. I save it, I close it, I go to summary. I can add an image, so I add it to all languages, and I choose here Samsung, so it is a Lenovo now, but anyhow, I close it, and I just click now on update. So click here on update and you can say okay and go. Okay, so still the product won't be shown just because of that, but you need to go here somewhere, employee self-service, synchronize product search data, and click on okay. And hopefully now it will be shown, but we will see. So catalog to preview catalog. Good, feel free to order something, so still the same, that's fine. And now I want to search for laptops and wow, now I have here my Lenovo. Yeah, unfortunately this is the picture of the item then, so not the one that I did before. Honestly, no clue what I did before the last step. But yeah, this one here is just the item master data image where I've tried to add it, but I couldn't. So yeah, the price here is currently zero, so I can say I just add it to my shopping cart. And I'm waiting until it is loading. Perfect. Yes, I want one. So as you can see, there would be any kind of different kind of options. It's, yeah, but for the moment, I can just say here, I want to add one to my cart, and it is at the moment now in my shopping cart. Yeah, I can also say, well, I want to search all category for a surface, and I can say on and search for it. Now I have here my Surface Pro. I'm also going to add it. Of course, it didn't add any prices, so therefore the price is zero, and I can add it to the cart as well. Now in my shopping cart, and if I go to my shopping cart, then I see here my two things. As you can see, what we did in the end in the policy, for example, is just that to say what am I able to do. So for example, I said I'm not able to override the price. So means nothing else. Let me find here in purchasing policy, and it was this one. If I go to edit, then somewhere I have here the requisition purpose, maybe, I don't think so, the reapproval, also not sure about it, but yes, I'm going to retire it, then I'll create a new one. No, definitely not this one. Was it this one? Retire, yes, and new one. No, it's also as well not. Somewhere where we have the possibility. Oh no, it's this one. Go to close. This one here. So, for example, price and discount transfer. Allow manual override per purchase requisition line, so it means nothing else, then I am afterwards able to add a kind of a price. Good, so this means nothing else, then quickly close it, and it is effective from now on. At least it should be, yeah, that's fine. So I'm going back to my procurement catalog 2, I'm going to have a look at the preview. And I want to order something more, so this means nothing else. Then I also want to have Samsung, and I'm searching for it. I didn't have Samsung, so I just search for phones. Windows phone, I click here on new, and still I'm not. Just the price, I think it is just not updated. But in the end, you should be able then to update the price. Okay, back to my shopping cart. So my shopping cart means nothing else now that I can say here order, and it would create a purchase requisition in the system. As I said, we had a blank system, so we do need to set it up as well. So purchase requisition in the end needs to have a workflow. So as you can see, if I would go in here, perfect. System already have a purchase requisition workflow, but we are just going to have a look at it quickly. So I just go to procurement and sourcing workflow, and then I would actually need to just create one of the type purchase requisition review. So just need to click in here and then search for the purchase requisition review, basically. Then you would end up on this screen, which is looking like this, as soon as it is open. Oh, come on. So it's still doing something, so it's still loading. I don't know what kind of workflow there is behind, maybe quite a big one, but we will see. At least it looks like it takes quite a while to load it, so yeah. So finally opened it. So as you can see in here, you have now the workflow. So there is basically just kind of a conditional decision. So it's really a procurement professional requirement. So then the new workflow would start. We actually just go for a quite simple one. So without anything, we just have, I'm also going to delete this one, if you also start with a blank workflow. So we just say in the end, yeah, it needs to be approved by someone. Yeah, there are quite a lot of other tutorials about workflows, therefore I'm really not going into details. So I just say, I just double click on it, say here step one, basic settings, please. Assignment. It's going to assign it to a user, so of course I have to approve it. Time doesn't matter. Single approval, so just me. Escalation, of course, as well. Not I close it. I go a step up. Perfect. In here, I think I don't need anything. No, no, and no. And I'm just going to save and close and OK. Going to activate the new version. So I click on OK. And it takes then again a while. Good. And it is approved. So now we can actually go back. I'll just quickly close all the enterprise portal stuff. So procurement catalogs again. Again to my catalog, preview catalog. Perfect, I still have my things in here, and I can also click here to check out. And now I can click on order, and I can say here the reason, general supplies, I want to add these two things. So I could choose a project, I don't need to click on next. And I say, well, yes, this is perfect, and I can say submit. And your request has been submitted, so a record of this order has been created for you, blah, 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 blah. So for me, it's done. So this means nothing else than I can click here of purchase requisition prepared by me, I guess. And if I do so, then it is loading. And when the load is finished, then we should see my purchase requisition. Yes, of course. So I see now, well, okay, here there is the purchase requisition. It is currently in review. So so I always see the state. Perfect. So this means nothing else than just by this, what we did now, a purchase requisition was created. Right, so you see now in here, so basically I, or specifically those things which are, so the purchase requisition, which are prepared or requested for me should be the same, because I added in the workflow that I am the one who needs to confirm it. So I can review it, I can say, well, yes, this is perfect. So I can say, as soon as the workflow engine went through it, I hope the workflow engine is running. If not, let's have a quick check. System administration, batch jobs. And workflow messaging processing, this would be a few tasks. Yes, those three, withholding, function, change status, waiting. And okay, how many recurrence is? No end date after 1 minute, okay. So, means nothing else than we need to wait 1 minute now. So I've just put it to waiting, which means nothing else than the workflow will start running in 1 minute, hopefully at least, and after. So you always need to check actually that the workflow batch job is running. If this is not the case, then actually nothing happens and you will just stay there where it was before. So actually where you just had purchase requisition, and you will never be able to approve it. So it will maybe take a while, so therefore just quickly click on pause. So, and perfect. So after I did that, it worked. So I can click now on batch job history, for example, and then I see, well, now it already started several times, so every minute it is going to start because of the recurrence, which is saying every minute this batch job will start. Just regarding the task, so if you would not have it, you just need to look that you have, or that you need to create here, just one, so you can add your lines. I call it however you want. In the end, just these three workflow classes needs to be in here that the workflow is working correctly. Okay, so this means now, since it is done, I can go back to purchase requisition prepared by me. So I am now my own boss, which means I can just go in here and I can say, well, I've ordered here a Lenovo and the Surface. So I can say, well, of course, this is perfect. So I can just click here. Yes, I click on approve. Perfect. I get a new laptop. I'm going to approve it. And now it is the same thing. So it is now again in the workflow engine. So this means nothing else than I need to wait until it is done. But of course, my job is done. So I'm the boss and I approved it. So I'm done with it. I'm not the purchaser and I'm not going to create a purchase order out of it. Therefore, I actually can directly go back in here, and then it's basically already fine for me, because my job is done. But actually, in the end, as soon as it is done, so yep, that's good. So means nothing else than now it should be released. So now the purchasing department's process starts. So the purchasing department can go in this menu item here and can say release the proof purchase requisitions. And if everything worked fine, then I see here, yep, perfect, my two things that I've created before. So now I see, well, okay, there is, in the end, two purchase requisitions which were done or which were created and are approved. So in here, you just see the approved ones. Those which are not approved, those won't be shown in here. So I can just say, okay, those two. Perfect, I create a new purchase order, and I can select the vendor account. So I can say in here this one and in here this one. Maybe just to say it is also possible, of course, so just click on cancel. Yeah, that's fine. So if I'm going to the item, and if I'm adding on the item a supplier, purchase. So nothing else than just the standard supplier. Yeah, it's not authorized, doesn't matter at all. And also the same for this item here, new details. And I'm adding here as well was created. So with the next one, it should appear, the vendor account should appear then. So I choose here the vendor account, and I click on OK. And now AX created a purchase order. So now the normal purchase order process starts. I can double click on it, and I'm ending up directly on the purchase order. Or, of course, I can just go over the AX surface to procurement and sourcing all purchase orders. So as you can see here, now I have here a normal purchase order, which has then the normal purchase order process. But of course, you will also see the purchase order in here. So this one with my two lines. And, well, maybe the last remark for this session. If you don't have the enterprise portal, then it is of course not possible to use the employee self-service thing. But of course, you can also just create here a new purchase requisition, and then it is actually the same case as before. So you can just go in here, and over the surface, you can in here directly say, well, I want to have here this one and and then it is actually the same thing, so also with this one here, so the new one that I've created, I just need to click here on submit, and then the workflow will start the same way as before. As I saw, I'm still not able to write the unit price, so there's just something maybe not activated on the policy. Good, perfect. I hope this helped you or showed you a little bit how to set it up. As I said, it was also my first setup, so I hope I didn't bore you with searching for correct things. And I wish you a very nice evening. Bye.